The low lake level pumping station here at Lake Mead ensures that we can draw water for the long-term future. It's also a project that came in on time and it came in under budget. And joining me now is Adriana Ventimiglia, who has some intimate knowledge of this facility. Thanks for coming on. How long have you been with the organization for?
I've been with the organization for 14 years.
Yeah, long time. And again, appreciate your knowledge going to our viewers about this place. Let's start with engineering. And I think it's an understatement if I said it's no small feat to be able to do what we did here, which is drill and blast 500 feet straight down. Actually, we're standing on the spot where we go 500 feet straight down and then connect to our third intake, which goes 3 miles into Lake Mead. Just a guess here, but I'm assuming a project like this, pretty unique, pretty one of a kind, and probably not attempted anywhere else in the world, maybe in different scenarios, but not specific like this.
You're correct, John. It is a very unique project in that it took years of planning with various groups of many backgrounds. We had planning, we had operations, we worked closely with our engineers and with our suppliers, with our contractors. We have pumps from Spain, from Japan, from Germany. We also have valves from China and a lot of equipment from here, from the U.S. as well.
Really a worldwide effort. Now let's talk about this drought and obviously what this facility, its role plays in this drought. Since 2000, we all know this, but the elevation at Lake Mead, it's dropped quite a bit, 130 feet since this drought began. So tell us what this facility does. You know, we're hoping Mother Nature changes course and the snowpack in the Colorado River Basin, it picks up again and we get more flows into Lake Mead. But if that doesn't happen, what role does this facility play?
Well, with a sustained drought, we saw that our two original pumping stations ran the risk of becoming inoperable. So L3PS, as we call it, was designed to operate at lower lake levels than the original two pumping stations. With that, L3PS can operate below dead pool, which is at elevation 895. And of course, dead pool is when water can no longer go through Hoover Dam, but that gives us access to a reliable supply of water.
Yeah, so we're essentially getting water from depths that we'd never have before here at Lake Mead. But it is in state's best interest, it's in everybody's best interest, obviously, to keep those lake levels as high as we can. As you mentioned, dead pool, we can't eventually, or we'll reach a point where if the drought continues, we can't feed downstream to California and Arizona and Mexico. So these states want to keep these lake levels higher, and this facility allows us to kind of have some partnerships with some states. So we have one going on right now. It's developing with the Metropolitan Water District of Southern California, where we invest in a big wastewater project that they have going on over there. And in exchange, we keep a portion of their Lake Mead water, and we could boost our annual supply by up to 8%, which is huge. But at the end of the day, we know conservation is big, right? It's the most cost-effective way to really protect our resources here in Lake Mead.
Correct. And please remember, have everyone remember that with each changing season, please update your clocks. And if you're not using your turf, please replace it. We have programs where we give you a rebate.
Yeah, up to $3 a square foot. Lastly, let's talk about maintenance here. You see this big row of pumps. There's a lot underground as well. And the big gantry crane behind us, which I'm really excited to step up there and maybe push a few buttons and see if I can't get that running.
Well, maintenance at L3PS is really ongoing, and we have a team that's dedicated to repair or replace any of these pumps or any other equipment. That said, as you can see, the pumps are fairly large, and they need to access the 220-ton crane, which we all want to go up there and try it out. So,
Adriana, thanks for coming on. Thanks for teaching us a little bit more about L3PS. Appreciate it.
It's been fun. Thank you.